All right, hello everyone, and now welcome to game number three in this series. So far, it has been this War Chief Rich game, as War Chief Rich has just been playing phenomenally well, constantly taking out his opponent. All right, so it looks like War Chief Rich is going to be going into... Wow, you can actually see the ally talk here. Apparently, they are not sitting next to each other or on Skype, but their communication and their ability has just been playing very, very well. Now, one of the things to keep in mind as well, we are looking at an undead versus night elf matchup, and they are just explaining to each other, and this is actually one of the key elements of playing any sort of team game. Communication, regardless if it's Warcraft 3, Starcraft 2, or a MOBA like League of Legends or Dota, if you don't have good communication with your partners, you're not going to be getting very far. And you can already see in the opening that they are actually hoping that they're going to be going up against Double Fiends. Now, Double Fiends is actually a very, very bad idea, just because you want to be able to cover what your opponent's weaknesses are going to be. Now, yes, Crypt Fiends are very, very helpful in game in 1v1 matchups, but in 2v2s, Crypt Fiends, they need a little bit of extra help. They just take too much damage up in that front line, so things could go awry very quickly. Now, we are going to be going Keeper of the Grove. I believe it's Keeper... is Starshape actually going to go Keeper of the Grove? I don't think so. He's probably going to stick onto that Priestess of the Moon and maybe get Keeper of the Grove second if he even bothers to tech to tier 2. All right, let's see. 3 DH coming. Not quite sure what 3 Demon Hunters coming. I don't imagine that. As we're now looking at Ancient of War already going after this Centaur Grove creep camp here in the center. What's happening for the Undead? Undead is going for a Death Knight and also a Death Knight. Both of them going for Death Knight. Tomb of Relics is there. Crypt Fiends are now being trained, so it does look like it will be both Crypt Fiends. And so we are going to be looking at a double Crypt Fiend build here as the Centaur Outrunner is going to get taken down. There's a Rune of the Watcher in a very good position right in the center portion of the map, as this Ancient of War is taking a lot of damage. All right, there goes another here. The Wisp has not really done that much repairing on this one poor Ancient of War. Ancient of War down to 120 hit points, and it looks like the Ancient of War should be fine, as the Demon Hunter is now going to finish it off with one more blow. There it goes. Level 2 on the Demon Hunter. Also has a Circle of Nobility, as the Ancient of War now backing off here. Meanwhile, let's take a look. You can see some Centaurs now just going very, very deep inside the Death Knight, doing a good job actually pathing the unit, as the Centaur now running back off to the north there. It is going to get taken out. Now a couple of Archers are all that are left. Once those Archers are down, the Death Knight will not be level 2, but we'll have some experience on the board. Meanwhile, down here, you can see Starshaped is going after the creep camps, trying to deny some experience. And Starshaped did a good job denying the experience on the Death Knight. So far, you can see that the Crypt Fiends are still in position here. The Priestess of the Moon now just backing away, buying time for War Chief Rich to really make a stronger play. You can see that there's also a Wisp in play here. Perhaps we will even see, are we going to see a kill steal? Yes, kill steal from the Priestess of the Moon, getting even more experience. The Death Knight has not gotten any, and that is just some really strong play so far, as you can now see War Chief Rich. They're checking for possible tower pushes. You are not going to see that much teching, though, as we're now looking at the Demon Hunter now coming back over here. All right, War Chief Rich now going after all of these Centaurs. It is not currently being repaired by any Wisp, so the Demon Hunter is really just working overtime trying to take this down. You can see that there is one... the Death Knight now going to come in here. Oh, double Death Coil could have been coming into play. There it is, now down to 39 hit points. Wow, that Death Knight unable to catch up there, but that was a little... Oh, beautiful Death Coil, only to be stopped by a Scroll of Town Portal. Beautifully done, as the Priestess of the Moon now tries to get away. The Death Knight now trying to chase, not going to be able to do very much either, as the rest of this creep camp has been cleaned up. Report my ally, please. Currently sitting at level 2, almost level 3 on his Demon Hunter, should be able to start mana burning through the Death Knight. The Death Knight now wandering around. The Priestess of the Moon still sitting at level 1. And are we seeing double Crypt Fiends? It looks like that is what we're seeing so far. as we're finally making a bit of a move here. All right, are we going to focus down? Why are you going after the Priestess of the Moon, who takes so little damage from Crypt Fiends? Should really be trying to focus down these poor, poor Huntresses, as we now see a 3-unit surround there. And Warchief Rich just laughing all the way to the bank here, knowing that he's got this one pretty much all set up. Now, Warchief Rich going to perhaps pick up a Naga. Yes, Naga Sea Witch has now been trained, and we are going to be going after one of the bases. Another huge mana burn onto the Death Knight. The Death Knight now trying to get away, but the Demon Hunter does have Boots of Speed and should be able to at least double mana burn that Death Knight down to 100 mana instead of his maximum capacity, and the Death Knight is a little bit worse for wear and cannot lead his army nearly as much. All right, Warchief Rich. This is actually really interesting, being able to see how much the communication there is. Warchief Rich saying that you should have expanded, but I don't even know where's a good expansion location. Perhaps back over there, as we now see a Tree of Life being brought into play. There is a Fountain of Health in that position there, as we are now going into the Yellow Army after this creep camp over here to the top right. You can see that this creep camp is going to get cleared up, but the Night Elf army comes in from behind. No real way to run, as the Crypt Fiends are now all trying to back off. The Crypt Fiends, are they going to be able to survive? Yes, they will, as now Priestess of the Moon is going to finish off this creep camp. It will not give her level 2. Actually, no, it will give her level 2. I take it back. There it is, and also picking up a Mantle of Intelligence. All right, Naga Sea Witch and the Demon Hunter now coming back across the center here. You can see that the Death Knight and the Crypt Fiends are trying to clear out this bottom left-hand side of the map. This Death Knight still sitting at level 1, and this is still just not looking all so good for Arming G. Report my ally, please. Seems to be higher up in level, but he is not playing as a team, and that's really what's causing a lot of problems. These two teams are just better in communication for Warchief Rich and Starshaped, as we are now finally getting into almost out of no upkeep. Let's see, we are at 34 over 50. Meanwhile, 42 over 50 here. Let's take a look at the Knight or the Undead armies. 36 over 40 compared to 36 over 40 as well. Both sides pretty even, as we are now going to be going into a little bit of a play here. What's happening? This one burrowed Crypt Fiend able to escape. The Naga Sea Witch taking a little bit of damage. And now there is that True Sight coming in from the Owl Scout. And it is not even trying to unburrow. There is the unburrow there. And here we go. A little bit of a play there, as the units are now just trying to run back. So far, the Crypt Fiends are now just being split up. And this is not good. And the sandwich play really, really just bad here. The Death Knight now trying to catch... Oh, gets the Naga Sea Witch. A very easy, quick kill for report. But he may end up losing one of his Crypt Fiends. No, it looks like the Crypt Fiend is going to be able to back off just in time. But another Crypt Fiend may get taken down. The Death Knight does not have enough mana for another Death Coil, losing another unit. All right, Warchief Rich saying we should have killed more units there. And I definitely believe that to be the case. The Lich is still trying to come over into position. Meanwhile, down over here, a little bit of a trailing battle, another 2v1, as the two armies of the yellow now finally getting together to do a little bit of a push, and Warchief Rich wisely calls to back off, knowing that that is not a good place to be. All right, let's see what's going to be happening next. The Crypt Fiends now making their way over, going to try and clear out this Rock Golem creep camp. Should be pretty easy. Meanwhile, the Death Knight, one Death Knight with a plenty of mana, the other one very, very low. And this Death Knight really just deciding to back off, hoping that the other heroes gain more experience. Double Lich. If you have double Lich, double Frost Nova, that is perhaps one of the scariest nuking compositions ever, as you can easily take down any fleeing hero with staggered Frost Novas to slow them down, and then Death Coils to finish them off. All right, the Troll High Priest, Ogre Lord, now taking down this creep camp. Looks similar to the red creep camps on Turtle Rock. Yellow is working together to try to clear out these creep camps. Meanwhile, Teal is clearing out the Fountain of Health and also this red creep camp at the same time. And it looks like, because of that Tree of Life, dealing a little bit of extra damage, it looks like Starshaped and Warchief Rich will be coming out ahead again, as he picks up a Book of the Dead. Demon Hunter, does he pick up anything useful? Don't see it. Naga Sea Witch, a Sobe Mask. Very nice in addition to the Talisman of Evasion. The Naga Sea Witch will be able to launch plenty of cold arrows in the upcoming fights. Now, still this red creep camp here. And let's see what's happening here. We're going to see the Druids of the Claw now making their way over. All right, they're going to do a little bit of a push. The Death Knight caught out of position. The Demon Hunter getting in a little bit of attacks there. The Death Knight now all the way in the far back as the Demon Hunter. Oh, Death Coil, day late and a dollar short as the Death Coil misses the already dead Crypt Fiend. We are looking at the slaughterhouse now coming, training up some obsidian statues. Perhaps a number of bears would be helpful. Meanwhile, down over here, a lot of crypt fiends once more. We are getting into a pit lord, not a crypt lord, excuse me, a crypt lord. So we are going to have that very nasty undead tri-hero. And if we perhaps see another pit lord as well, we are at Black Citadel, a third pit lord would pretty much mean constant hero nuking for quite some time. If you can keep the opponent up in the air for a long, long time, that is just going to be a really, really sad, sad day as a mana burn does go down on the Lich. No Frost Nova. And now here we go. There's a bit of a battle. All right, the pit lord comes up. There's the Impale. And there's a mana burn. There's a Death Coil. There's the Frost Nova. And oh, the Rejuvenation. Not enough. The Demon Hunter at level 3 gets taken down as the rest of the army now coming back over. Death Knight sitting at level 3 comes in for a quick heal. And all of a sudden, what's been a dominant game so far by the Night Elf players, they are still ahead because of that extra base in the back. But losing that hero has to be a bit demoralizing for War Chief Rich. All right, let's take a look at the upcoming fight. The Death Knight sitting at level 3, the Lich sitting at level 2, and really, the Obsidian Statues and a Pit Lord being added in as well. So we are going to be seeing the Pit Lord. It was just my spider sense tingling in terms of knowing what was going to be coming into play. It looks like he doesn't want to fight this fight until the Pit Lord or the Demon Hunter is back. War Chief Rich hoping to get some extra gold. You can see that this base off over here, Rock Golem has not been crept out, but there's the Moonwell, and now this Tree of Life needs to get taken down and taken down quickly. All right, Wisp, is it going to get detonated in time? No, oh yes, it does. It gets detonated in time as the Pit Lord now going after the Tree of Life. It looks like the Tree of Life is just going to fall very quickly. We may see mass detonations here. No, we are not going to see. Oh, there is Rain of Fire, and there it is straight up on top of that fight there. All right, finish off the Tree of Life. The Tree of Life does go away and both armies teleport back. Was it worth it? I don't think so, but it does mean that they do not have to worry about the additional economy for Starshape for quite a while, since not only does he have to build a new Tree of Life, he has to entangle that gold mine. All right, Starshape saying that this is bad. We can now take a look at them trying to clear out the center fountain of health off over here. The undead army is looking pretty strong right now. The Pit Lord, the Crypt Lord, the two Death Knights, and the Liches doing a great job here. We are also going to be using that Fountain of Health to try to heal up all the lower hit point units, and also now recovering a whole bunch of mana. Let's see. The Pit Lord does have the Scroll of Town Portal, and what is going to be happening next? The Death Knight has a Pendant of Mana, so very, very high mana there. As we're looking at the Lich trying to get to level 3, he looks like he will be able to get exactly to level 3, which means much, much stronger Frost Novas. Now, the next couple of fights need to be engaged with both teams playing at the same, or both teams fighting together. If you get caught split apart at this stage in the game, things can go bad extremely quickly. All right, let's take a look here. The bears now making their way into position. You can see that the Crypt Fiends and the other units are here. And oh, are we going to actually go for an engagement? No, we are not, because that's the same team. Obviously, the other team off over here. Big hit point on the Crypt Lord. Is it really? Not really. Or 750 hit point. Or wait, the Crypt Lord. Crypt Lord, no, 675. And yes, he was talking about the Potion of Greater Healing, which, yes, it is, in fact, there. now they're also making sure that there are no banshees, because yes, bears would all of a sudden turn the tide extremely quickly, as the bears are now backing off. Tree of Life being built here, Tree of Life being built here as well, and that economic advantage may turn out to be the deciding factor here, as all the armies are now looking to back off. A couple of ghouls now making their way to the 2 o'clock position to try and stop this expansion before it gets going. The armies now need to make their way over, and perhaps even using the waygate would be a better use than trying to get to the other side of the map quickly. All of a sudden, Warchief Rich is going to go ahead and clear out all of these ghouls. That army is pretty much going to fall, or these two ghouls are pretty much going to fall apart there, as Starshaped wisely decides to back and go back to Warchief Rich's base. All right, Starshaped entangling that gold mine now. Meanwhile, we are looking at a Wisp who was trying to grow up to be a Tree of Life. That's not going to be coming at it all too well, needing me to come from behind. And we are now looking to see where these players are going to position themselves. The Pit Lord, still sitting at level 1, really needs to get to level 3. And now this is going to be a straight-up pincer attack. All right, here you go. The Destroyers are here. The Crypt Fiends are here. And now we could perhaps be seeing a little bit of attack here. The Death Knight, the Pit Lord gets up to level 2. Are we going to perhaps see an Impale? And we need to see an Impale here. All of a sudden, the Crypt Lord's in trouble. There is the Impale up, as a Mana Burn does hit the Death Knight. Both sides fighting, but the Bears are now engaging straight up against the Crypt Fiends. A Pit Lord does get healed again. Out of mana, though, Staff of Preservation saves another, and the Pit Lord at level 1 does get taken down. So far, the Crypt Lord is the only hero that's pretty much left here. Is constantly getting healed, but the army, the Green Night Elf army, is just pushing their way with superior positioning, and I believe that is pretty much going to be the game, as the Crypt Lord falls as well. Better positioning, constant moving in, as the Bears, and also use of Scrolls of Healing, healing up multiple units. Those Scrolls of Healing definitely worth their weight in gold, healing up the entire army, as the Death Knight now forced to use a Scroll of Town Portal. All right, low hit point Bear, is it going to get taken out? No, it is not. It is able to teleport away just in time, as the Crypt Fiends are now backing off again. All right, the Destroyers are all there. Obsidian Statues, Pit Lord was resurrected at level 1. Now in comes the chase again, back up in the middle, as the Pit Lord may try to come in for perhaps a Rain of Fire. No, not gonna work out all too well, as the Frost Nova does hit. Demon Hunter is right there. There's a Mana Burn on the Pit Lord. No more Rain of Fire, as the Pit Lord without mana is just a very, very big tanky unit. So far, the Death Knight, unable to do much, does get off another Death Coil, but now out of mana, as the Demon Hunter was able to heal back up. Staff of Preservation saves another Bear. Demon Hunter now sitting up to level 5, as the Crypt Fiends should really be focusing onto the Huntresses, not focusing them down at all, but or even perhaps the Bears at this point, as you can see that there is still the Destroyer trying to absorb more mana and deal more damage here. This long, long fight still coming in. And the Pit Lord is back. The Death Knight falls at level 4. And as the Death Knight falls at level 4, the Demon Hunter, Dark Ritual, there goes the Death Knight at level 4 again. But also with the Demon Hunter. The Demon Hunter now falls. It looks as though the Pit Lord's going to fall again. And Hero, it is a bad day to be a hero in this game, as a Bear now falls as well. The Lich now trying to back off. The army, the Crypt Fiends, are not being microed here. This should have been a very, very easy micro. Just back off with those Crypt Fiends. But instead, still continuing that chase. The Pit Lord, very low on hit points. Or no, it's not the Lich, not low on hit points. The Pit Lord trying to engage low on mana, unable to save the unit. And the Lich unable to dodge a spear, even though he was uphill. And there's the GG. 3 straight games for Warchief Rich. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening.